Hello everyone. Today we are going to start with chapter 1 of economics of standard 12, that is graphs in economics. The chapter covers with introduction, meaning of diagram and a graph, types of diagrams, types of graphs, use of technology in study of economics. We are starting with today introduction and meaning of a diagram and graph, as well as we will cover importance and various important thing to be considered while drawing a diagram. So today in this class we are going to cover introduction, meaning of a diagram and graph, its importance and aspects to be considered while drawing a diagram or a graph. Starting with introduction, economics explains and analyzes various economic events occurring in a real world. An analysis of statistics provided by the state, banks and international organizations is very purposefully done in economics. Layperson do not get interested in discussions and analysis of events done by experts, but their attention is drawn when important aspects of certain events and matters pertaining to economic changes are presented by way of pictures. And this way, certain information which must be conveyed to people reaches them. Generally, two types of pictures are used to depict such information, and these are called diagrams and graph. What this paragraph is trying to convey is that normal person is not interested in discussions or events that are going on economic basis. Say for example, when in TV channels, when certain experts are giving their views or they are giving their opinion, we as a normal human being are not attracted to it. But when the TV screen represents pictures or diagram, we easily get attracted and we easily understand what information that picture, diagram or graph is trying to convey. So economic is useful to us or normal person in conveying message with help of these pictures, and that are diagrams and graphs. Now we are moving with meaning of a diagram and a graph. First, diagram. Diagram is presentation of observable data by way of picture. Scales and measurement are used while drawing a diagram. Thorough knowledge of statistics is not required to draw. A diagram is drawn for data which are presented in discrete frequency distribution. In other words, diagram is drawn for self-explanatory data, and layperson do not require detailed knowledge of statistics in order to draw or understand a diagram. A diagram is used by advertising companies to draw attention, by government to provide information, and by social organization to spread awareness. Now, this paragraph, diagram. What is diagram? Diagram is drawn with help of measurements and scales. Without measurement and scale, you cannot draw diagram. Second thing is, a diagram doesn't require a knowledge of statistics. Means normal person can easily understand without any information or without any explanation from other person. A normal person can easily understand what diagram wants to convey, because in that no specific statistical knowledge is required. It is self-explanatory. Third thing is, diagram is used for discrete frequency distribution. Now, what is discrete frequency distribution? In 11th standard in statistics, you have learned what is discrete frequency distribution. Discrete frequency distribution is, here I am giving one example. Say for example, here it is price and here it is demand. When, what is relation between price and demand? As price increases, naturally demand for a product or quantity demanded decreases. When price is rupees 10, demand will be 100. When price is 20, demand will be 90. When price is 30, demand might be 80. When price is 40, demand might be 70. When price is 50, demand will fall to 60 quantity demanded. This is discrete data. For this type of discrete data, we use diagram. Is it clear, everyone? Now we are moving with what is graph. A graph is a presentation of observable data by a way of picture, but graph is drawn for statistical information which are not self-explanatory. A graph is drawn for data with a continuous frequency distribution. In order to simplify such data, statistical tools is made. A graph is also drawn for other type of complex unclear statistical information. Though thorough knowledge of statistics is essential to draw and understand graph, a graph can be extended over or more of the four coordinates obtained by intersection of x and y axis on a plane. It cannot be drawn without taking an appropriate measurement. A graph is generally drawn on graph paper. Graphs are used by researchers and educationists. Graphs are not used to convey information in general public. Now, what is graph? Graph is a thing which requires statistical information when drawn. It is not self-explanatory. Means when normal person look at a graph, they cannot easily understand. They require some expert or some person who has statistical knowledge. Second thing is graph is drawn for continuous frequency type of data. Now what is continuous type of frequency of data? Here it is given. See example. This is income class, number of people, class of marks and number of students. This type of data are known as continuous frequency. In 11th standard statistics you have learned. So this graph is drawn for continuous frequency distribution. And this type of graph can be presented on a graph paper where x-axis and y-axis are there, where four quadrant are there, 1, 2, 3, 4 quadrant are there. You have drawn graph in 11th standard. Second thing, graph are used by researcher and educationist, where diagram are used by advertising company, government organization and social organization for providing information. Here graph are used by researcher and educationist. Why? Because here researcher and educationist have special knowledge about statistics, so they can use graphs. Second thing, graph are not used to convey information to general public. For general public, graph are not used. Here table is given. I explained in previous slide only what is discrete frequency distribution with help of price and demand example. Here also same is given, and continuous frequency. Now I will sum up the topic with help of difference. I will make you to understand difference, and it will be easy for you to understand what is difference between graph and diagram. First is diagram. First is diagram. Let us see the difference between both of them. Diagram. And here is graph. Okay. Diagram are self-explanatory. Self-explanatory means by seeing diagram, person can understand it easily without any person's help. But graph are not self-explanatory. Here, expert or a person with statistical knowledge is required for a normal person to understand graph. Second thing is, here statistical knowledge is not required. And here statistical knowledge is required. Third thing, it is for discrete data. And here it is for continuous data. Fourth thing, it is used by advertising company, government organization, and third one is advertising company, government organization and social organization for providing information. Here it is used by researcher and educationist. I hope now it is both the points are very clear to you, as I have some of the things. Now we are moving with importance of diagrams and graphs in economics. We are studying these diagrams and graphs. As we said, normal public is not interested, but with the help of diagram and graph, they are attracted. So there might be certain importance. What is that importance we are going to study right now in this slide? First importance is study of subject is made easier and less confusing. The subject of economics, which is difficult and complicated, is made easier and less confusing with the help of diagram and graphs. Okay. Second importance is trends of economic parameters over various years can be observed through a single diagram or graph. Now trends. In 12th standard, you will come across a time series also. In that, you will come to know what is trend. But right now, I'm giving you one example that is of trend. In this situation of coronavirus, before coronavirus, what was a trend or what was a selling pattern of normal goods? Means, say for example, food item. People were normally consuming according to their consumption. But during lockdown, for certain period of time, they have blocked. Means consumption was continuing, but purchase was blocked because of closure of shops and all things. But after lockdown, when unlock came, when all the shops reopened, then again with a mass consumption, people started to purchase more items than previously because of lockdown. Okay, so trend changes. First, trend was normal, then during lockdown trend blocked. Means sale was not there, so here there was no sale, no purchasing. But after lockdown, when shops reopened, then beyond normal things were seen, so trend increased. This was there, and this we can see with the help of diagram and graphs. Changes occurring in various sectors of economy can also be easily understood. Changes. The same example we continue, then this change we can see. First it was normal sale, then sale for certain time duration stopped, then again when unlock came, then again sale rised with a boom in purchasing. Fourth point is comparison can be easily drawn for distribution of some economic parameters between groups and class economic. Groups and class, regions, sectors, as well as time period. Means, so now we take example of class or region. Migrant, say for example, we are taking example of migrant workers, then middle class person, then effect of lockdown on luxurious or high class people. Or do you think all have the same change? Do you think all have suffered the same way during this lockdown? No. It is quite often that migrant workers might have affected more, and middlemen have affected moderate level, and luxurious people might have affected less because of their luxurious lifestyle. So this comparison between different class group can be easily understood with the help of diagram and graph. Different region like rural region, urban region, that way we can make out metropolitan cities. Okay, then sector they are talking about. Sector means right now at showpiece or article shop, gift article shop we can take, then FMCG goods, fast moving consumer goods we can take, then power supply sector we can take. This means this corona effect only we can see, no, among this all sectors we can compare easily with the help of this graph and diagram. And time period I suggested of coronavirus, before coronavirus, during coronavirus period, and after that, after 2020, before 2020, like that way. Now when fifth point, when many aspects of economics which are found apparently difficult are presented through a diagram and graph the time and effort of a presenter in explaining and of a reader in understanding these aspects is saved. Means here what they are saying, time and effort of presenter in explaining is saved. Time and efforts. Right now, if I have to give information about corona effect, then I have to explain lot of stuffs from 2019, then during coronavirus period, lockdown period, after that, I have to explain all stuff to normal public. But if I am presenting my data with the help of diagram or with the help of graph, then it will be easy for a normal public to understand, and my time and my energy, my efforts, all will be saved. This was all about importance. Last one importance is remaining. That is on next page, page number 3. Sixth importance, certain difficult principles of economics are easily understood with the help of diagrams and graph. Difficult principle of economics are easily understood with the help of diagram and graph. For example, the concept of expansion and contraction of demand and supply, price elasticity of demand and supply are made easier by way of pictures, and the trends of macroeconomic parameters can be clarified by the way of time series graph. See this time series graph in statistics 12th standard, you will come to across that things. For instance, the short-term and long-term irregular fluctuations in agriculture or the regular fluctuations in some of the industries are calculated by the method of time series, and the trends are presented by the way of time series graph. Here what they are trying to explain is, in 11th standard you have learned demand and demand, supply, price elasticity, all these things you came across, and along with that explanation their diagram and graphs were there. Why they have put diagrams and graph along with that all principles or law of diminishing marginal utility was there, law of demand was there, price elasticity was there, income elasticity was there. All these principles of economics below that you were given diagram. Why that diagram was given? Yes, exactly, diagram was given or the graph was given or the picture was given for easily explanation. Here if it is price and here it is demand, and expansion and contraction is there, means here quantity demanded will be keep on changing due to price change. So by looking on this diagram only you can easily understand the whole stuff. You don't require to read. By reading once and by looking at the picture you can easily understand. So this way diagram and graphs are very useful to understand. Now I am summing up the importance. First importance was to study easier and make thing easy and confusing. Make thing easy. Second thing was we can study trend. Present trend, what was there? Past trend, what was there? In future, what will be the trend? We can estimate that. Third thing is changes occurring in various sectors. We can see the changes. We can study changes with help of diagram and graph. Fourth thing was comparison can be made easy with within the regions, within the class or groups, and across a time period, comparison can be made easy. Fifth point was time and energy is saved of a explainer or of a presenter. Time and energy. Sixth point was that economic concept can easily be understood. Economic concept can be easily understood with the help of diagram and graph. These are all six importance of diagrams and graphs in economics. Now we are moving with next and the last topic of today, that is aspects to be considered while drawing a diagram or graph. Like in I told you, in diagram we cannot draw diagram randomly. जैसे मन में आया वैसे ही कर दिया, ऐसा नहीं होता है. We have to follow certain criterias, we have to take certain care, steps are to be taken and followed properly to draw a diagram or graph. So what are that steps? What are the things which is helpful in drawing pictures and diagrams? First thing is choice of type of diagram or graph and their presentation. Means one data, say for example demand and price is there. Here it is price and here it is demand. We can draw bar graph, we can draw histogram, we can draw polygon, we can draw pie chart, everything we can draw. But you have to make a choice like this, that whatever picture you use, it becomes more effective. It can be, it provide a more information in small figure or in small picture. So first main thing is choice. Make a choice that way that your information or your data becomes more effective with the help of picture. Second is clarity. Clarity means in if you are drawing on graph paper, then someone is erasing lot of time, messy things, that should be avoided. Messiness is not looking good. It is confusing in mind of who is seeing the graph. So your picture must be neat and clear. You can use different colors and shades to express different components of pictures. Like in pie chart, you can use different colors to highlight certain things. Scales and measures. This is most important thing. You cannot draw randomly. To make your picture look appropriate in size, scale is must. Your picture otherwise will look bulky or thin or very tall or very short. So appropriate scales and measure are needed to draw diagram or graphs. Representation of axis. What should be represented on x-axis? What should be represented on y-axis? In 11th standard economics, you have learned in first chapter. X-axis will have dependent variable and y-axis will have independent variable. This you have learned. So proper information. And if you are not representing, you are drawing and keeping like this, then also it is worthless. You have to write here what you have shown on x-axis. You have to denote x and y. Here you have to write price. Here you have to write demand. If you are not writing this information, then your graph or your diagram is useless. Okay. Fifth point is data table and a data source. Now, what is data table and data source? Diagram or graph, you cannot draw randomly. That you dreamt last night and you thought of drawing diagram. It is not so. You have some source. You have some material from where you draw a graph or diagram. Data table means what? Here, there is difference between both of them. I will explain you that. What is data table and data source? Table means what? There it will be row and column. And there you will get ready-made information. While in source of data, you will have a stuff of information. You will have lot of information. And from that, you have to make your data. Means you have to make your table in row and column wise. Means what it is saying? Data table means you have row and column and information is provided ready-made. Okay, information is already given. While in data source, all stuff will be given, and from this stuff you have to point out your content for what you have to make diagram and table. Now last point is method of calculating the data. Method of calculating the data means what? You have represented in graph and diagram the things like bar graph you have drawn, okay? But now if you are drawing polygon means this mid value. Okay, mid value are drawing. Now polygon, how you arrive at polygon? Polygon you consider at a mid value. So you have to show the mid value of class. Say for example 2 and 10, then 12 divided by 2, that is 6. 6 is mid value. So here you have put this a point at 6. So this way you have to provide a mid value in graph. Means you have to show a method of calculating the data, how you have arrived at this type of graph. So method is must. Now again I am summing again, I am showing you all the importance, and we will wind up this class by this important topic, that is considering things while drawing graph. First is choice. First you have to make choice which type of diagram or graph you have to use, and you have to make your picture more effective by using an appropriate choice. Second is clarity. Clarity is must. Your picture must look neat and clear. Third is scales and measurements. Without scale and measurement, you cannot draw a diagram or graph, because it is the main thing. Third is representation of axis. On x-axis and y-axis, you have to represent what you have denoted over there. X-axis, say for example, x-axis you have taken demand, y-axis you have taken rupees or price, then you have to show that. Data table and source of data. From where you are drawing graph and diagram, that thing you have to mention. Data table means ready-made information you have provided with a row and column. While source of data means you have given a lot of stuff of information. From that you are exploring your data, and then you are putting it on graph and diagram. Sixth and last point is method of calculating the data. Method in calculating the data means data is not randomly presented. There is some of the tools or method that is used, that is shown, so that person can easily understand the data. This is type of diagram. This we will do in next our class. Thank you.